your department. It enhances community affairs is something that we learn every day. By communicating and understand the Jewish custom and all different faith-based communities, how we operate and what our religious rules are, I believe, and I meet these sheriffs and chiefs on a daily basis, and they tell me, you know what, by understanding our custom, you make our lives easier. So we're here today, and all these local police chiefs, I know the summer is coming up, and you guys are scratching your head. How many times will Rabbi Friedman call me about an issue, about a problem? But I want to thank you for your support for previous years. I know it's been tough sometimes to deal with communities on the roads. There's issues. We have the EMS going on the roads. We have different concerns about coming up on sundown Friday night, where sometimes people are stranded in traffic. We have here from the United States Border Patrol. I know we had an issue before the Sukkot holidays where our religious item were holed up in customs, and they were kind enough, and I want to give her a round of applause for really coming through and understanding that she kept it. I'm saying she, so I apologize. The United States Customs, I just want to give you an example, kept loads of containers that had a certain religious item. I'm not even going into the fact that it was worth over $200,000, and I'm not even going into the fact that without that religious item, us, the Jewish faith, wouldn't be able to do the religious requirements on a certain holiday. But when I made the phone call, and the supervisor, who wasn't that sensitive, said, you know what, within about a week, we'll get back to you through a letter what the results are. And I was trying to explain that within 24 hours, the holiday is going to be over, and the entire shipment is worthless, not even worth 50 cents. So Jana, and through all these officials by Customs and DHS, thank you for being sensitive to the Jewish community. Thank you for doing everything that you will continue to do. I also have to thank a good friend of mine that really helped me put together today's meeting. Don Redden, are you still here, Don? Don, thank you so much for working on behalf of the Jewish community. I know you have been appointed a few years ago. Many rabbis have counted on you with these local towns to advocate for us, and I know it hasn't been easy, but thank you so much for all you have done. I also want to thank Scott from ICE, who, I must say, got to know him a few months ago with his dignity, with his sensitivity in dealing with the Jewish faith and with all faiths. I personally visited his office in Federal Plaza. And when you walk into that room, he has numerous of messages on the wall showing how sensitive he is to religious faith. And I commend you for that, Scott. Thank you so much for that. In conclusion, I don't want to keep up your time. Sheriff Sedino, Chief Wilson from TNAC, and all the rest of you, I want to thank you for your tremendous support to the Jewish community. And last but not least, a man that I can say is the example of community affairs, like Rabbi Kalbach said, who every time you talk to him before a summer or before an event, when we started talking about this August 1st event that's coming up in the Meadowlands, within 10 minutes finding out that there's going to be planning the August 1st event, he made phone calls, sent messages to The Rock. My good friend Dave Cipriano from The Rock, thank you so much for all you've done. And without further notice notified literally hundreds of law enforcement agencies that's going to be involved in making sure that this event is going uneventful and with peace and safety and security. So, Major Lewis, in conclusion, thank you so much for being what you are, and you're an example of community affairs. And let's give him a round of applause, Major Lewis.